Now that we have some Groovy under our belts, we're in a much better position to understand what's going on inside a Gradle build script. Just like a closure can have a delegate object, the entire build script delegates to a project object. All the keywords in the Gradle DSL are properties of, or methods on, the project object. For instance, the project object has a method called task for declaring tasks. It accepts the name of a new task, and optionally, a configuration closure, which we'll talk about shortly. If we run Gradle tasks to have a look at all the tasks that are currently defined, we see under other tasks, my task one that we just defined. All right, everything's working so far. Because the entire build script delegates to the project object, we can actually go ahead and leave that off when we're declaring tasks. Also, because Groovy syntax is awesome, we can knock off those parentheses as well, since this is just calling a function. Now this next part is tricky. Gradle actually reaches into Groovy's execution model and uses an advanced Groovy feature called an abstract syntax tree transformation, the upshot of which is you can knock off the quotes as well. This is not a thing you need to understand super deeply, however, we do have more information in the demo code provided with the class. Now that we've declared a task, we can also configure some properties on it. So we can give myTask4 a description, and we can give it a group. If we then run Gradle tasks again, this is what we see. Here's the group up here, and here's the description. The most important property of a task is the list of actions the task will perform. Instead of setting the actions property directly, we add a closure to the end of the list of actions to perform using the doLast method. So, let's give task4 a try. Gradle helpfully tells us that it ran myTask4, and that it went ahead and printed the statement. There's a few other ways to add closures to that list of actions for the task to perform. We can add doFirst to add a task onto the front of the list. We can also use the leftShift operator, which does exactly the same thing as doLast. This is nice because it allows us to use this very compact syntax, and this is what you'll see most often when people are declaring very simple tasks in Gradle. We can also declare a task and then immediately pass it a closure to execute as its action. This is an extremely common pattern, and is probably the most common way that people declare simple Gradle tasks. Instead of configuring a task line by line as we were doing previously, we can also pass a configuration closure when we're defining a task. The configuration closure delegates to the task object, so it can go ahead and set the description, the group, and the actions of the task. Now you may have noticed something a little bit weird about that configuration block. We were trying to assign this string to description, but there's no equal sign here. Well, Gradle's actually done something very clever. For every property, it's created a setter with the exact same name. So this line is actually a function call omitting the parentheses, because Groovy. Assignment also works just as well. There's only one gotcha with this, and that is if you're assigning a collection to a property in a configuration closure, you gotta use the equal sign. Just a thing to keep in mind. One more thing to know about tasks. Some task properties can be set in the task declaration, like this. However, not all properties can be set this way, so check out the course code for the full story. The only time you actually have to use this syntax is when you're declaring a typed task, which we'll talk about soon.